I have been searching, as many of you have probably been searching, for what seems like an eternity. And I literally had to go to another country to get what's in this box. We're going to open it right now. All right, so welcome back. This is going to be a different kind of video. This is, well, obviously this is not Cottonelle. I haven't been searching for Cottonelle. I know you haven't been. Well, we're past the whole, pandemic stuff. So we all have toilet paper by now, I would hope. But this is a different kind of unboxing. There's no comics in here. No, I'm not getting into toys or cards or anything like that. This is actually, I'm just going to open it up and then we'll talk about it. So let's just, and I'm literally opening this up in front of you guys. So if this is not what it's supposed to be, I'm going to be a little bit pissed. Because this has been one hell of a wait. And we have, yes, Hanger 9, Pro Trim, Han 101. Brand new in box, it's supposed to be. So, yeah, it looks like it's brand new, wrapped, sealed. Oh, yeah, it smells brand new. Got the second shoe, got the plate. All right. So, yeah. I know a lot of people have been trying to find this because Hanger 9 and Horizon Hobby, the owners of Hanger 9, they discontinued this. They discontinued the Han 145, which is the big iron with the big dial, the dial on the top. So the reason why, let me explain what happened. I've been searching all over the place, every single hobby shop for like the last year. I would search for Han 101, Pro Trim Sealing Tool, all these things, Facebook Marketplace, Mercari, OfferUp, Nextdoor, every place you could think of, and couldn't find it anywhere. So then I just said, you know what? I've got friends in Canada. One of my friends lives in Winnipeg and his girlfriend lives in Chicago. So I was like, you know what? If I can find one, maybe I could work something out where I could get it. So I found one in Vancouver. This was, I swear to you, I think this might be the last new inbox in North America. I found it in Vancouver. I tried to order it. They would not ship to the United States. I asked them. I wrote to them and asked them. They would not ship to the United States. I wrote to a bunch of other shops that were within the whole Horizon Hobby network. None of them would help me out. A lot of them just said, oh, no, we don't have them. Try shopping around or whatever. I'm like, dude, you can't even just contact one of your other stores and be like, hey, does anybody have this? No, they didn't even do that. One of the places didn't even write me back. So, and these are local stores too. So I must have contacted 5 stores locally and then this one store in Vancouver, Ricky's. I want to give them a shout out because they actually had it and it was as delivered. It was as promised, but it doesn't say. Ricky's something in Vancouver. Yes, thank you to them for actually having this. So what I ended up doing was I had it shipped. I went online. I paid for it. And I used my friend's address in Manitoba, in Winnipeg. Then his girlfriend happened to be up there for his daughter's birthday the week that it was delivered. So it just worked out so perfectly that everything went fine up to that point. She came back on Sunday, sent it out on Tuesday because I wasn't going to ask her to go first thing Monday when she just came back from her international week-long trip. So it went out Tuesday. It was supposed to, it went out Tuesday. Today is now Saturday when I'm recording this. It was supposed to be here yesterday, but because my condo, our array of boxes only has like 2 working parcel lockers, the postal worker, I don't know what the hell the story was. They said that they came and tried to deliver it, but there was no room. So I left a note and that was it. I went down. There was no note on my front door, on the lock, you know, on the post box or on the inside. I had no idea what the hell was going on. So later in the day, I found her and I was like, hey, I already did this. I already signed up for the redelivery and I left specific instructions on there to please call me and I will come down and pick it up from you because I need this. And I told her, this is the only one that it seems like this is the only one left in North America. I cannot have this getting lost in your system or going back to the sender. I mean, even though the sender was my friend, it still would have been a hassle. So thankfully, I just went down on a whim and she was there and I got this. So sorry for everybody else that, you know, didn't have a friend in Canada. I got lucky and I got this. So, you know, just for a little change of pace, I wanted to show that, you know, just because something might seem impossible, it actually could be very possible if you bust your ass to try to find, you know, try to make it work. Now the problem is, where do you find other ones? And by the way, I know that there are other ones on Amazon. You know, let's just take a look real quick. I'll bring up Amazon and we'll look at them. But yeah, I'm just not a fan, to be honest. I'm really not. So let's go over to the screen share, pull up the window. Okay. So let's take a look and see what the other ones are. Let me just resize this, make sure you could all see it. All right, so we have Clover Iron Mini. Okay, so Clover Mini Iron. That's one of them. You have this one. It's $25, but I mean, if we just look at it, I don't know. I just don't know. It honestly looks cheap. Now, when you look at, if you've ever had the 145, the heavy iron, it's the same build as the 101, the mini iron, the ceiling iron. The build is the same. It feels strong. And I also, well, not the one that comes with it, but the shoe also looks like it's a better fit. This, I don't know. It just seems like you don't have, this one just seems, it's not as precise to me. And the way it looks on here, it looks like it could like spin around. I don't know. Just again, just the way the way it looks, I'm just not sure about it. I don't know. I just had a bad feeling. If I wasn't going to get this one, the other one was going to be, they have another one as well. I mean, you have these kind as well. This is just called Tiny Iron Bread. And the brand name is Arakimi. It's $19.99 and 20% coupon. Yeah. But again, I mean, it just doesn't, I don't know. It doesn't look like, I don't know, just the feel that I get. It does, again, this one, it doesn't look as precise. It kind of, and a lot of them, especially when you don't have brand behind it, like Hanger 9 has, it's a brand that thousands of people in the comic book industry and the modeling industry use. You know, it's just one of those things where you're just like, I want to go with a known quantity. I didn't want to sit, you know, go with something unknown. You know, then you have this one, which is another one. It's $19.99. It looks like the same exact thing, just a different handle with the digital reader. Other than that, it's not very different. But then there was one, XO, I think it was called ESXO, EXS. I can't remember the name of it for the life of me. It looked like the better of the remaining options, but yeah, now I can't think of the name of it. Because I did have it. I was looking at it. Oh, here's another Clover Mini. This one I definitely did not want to buy. This one I was looking like, what in the hell is this thing? This looks like it would be just so clumsy to use that, you know, I didn't understand what this was supposed to be. I mean, there's this giant case, and then you had this little pipe coming out of it holding the foot, the shoe. I was like, yeah, I don't know what that is. And granted, you could use it for different applications with different sizes. Like you could add a ginormous shoe on it. But if you've already got this one, what do I need that for already? You know? I wish I could remember the name of the other one, because that was one that I was seriously... I was looking at. I actually was going to buy it in case I could not find this. And of course, here you can see, here's a ceiling, the large one, but they're $91. Like these are the big ones to replace the 145. I wish I could remember the name of this. I really wish I could. And I wish they linked to that specific one in here, you know, as a comparative version, but they just don't. Products related, this is sponsored. I doubt they're going to do that. But I'm pretty sure it was like EXO or something. And maybe I could pull this up. EXO Iron. Here. EXO Rigid Mini Iron. This is it. This is the one. This is the exact thing that I was talking about. You know, this has a smaller, and this is the reason why. This had, similar to the Hand 101, this has a smaller foot. So it's more precise in a specific area. You're not sitting there and using the, you know, a giant space, you know, a giant footprint to try to get like one little spine tick, because then you have a chance of doing damage to other areas. So I liked it for this, but at the same time, you could see how big and bulky this part is here. I just thought, I don't know how, you know, like when you look at, I'll bring it up to the other one. When you look at, I lost the shoe already. Oh, it's stuck in here. Crap. Here it is. When you look at this shoe, I have to open it up. The shoe that you would use, you could see how flat it is, you know, and narrow. So it's very flat. It's, you know, it's very thin. You know, I mean, I can't even get my fingers to touch. If we look at it relative to, you know, it's about as thick as the flap. It's actually thinner than the flap on the box. That's how thin it is. So, to me, it's a more precise, you know, it'd be something more precise. Now, I could be wrong. That's for sure, because I've never used this before. But it's something that, you know, this is what traditionally has been used for pressing comics, cleaning comics, you know, spine ticks, all that stuff. So, you know, I just felt like, hey, I want to go with the original. You know, it's kind of like going with a knockoff ink for your printer. Like, do you really want to take that chance? You know, especially with all the reports that, hey, you know, a lot of these knockoffs will leak, but, you know, it is what it is. Now I've got this. I could try to press some of my comics a little bit better, considering the fact that this is, like I said, it's very large. It's a lot heavier. So when you're trying to press out, you know, a small area, you don't want to have the rest of the book coming in contact with this, because there's a chance that you could damage it. You know, you want that precise nature of that little foot. But yeah, so hey, if you live in Canada, I don't know, maybe you could find one of these up there if you're needing it, because I didn't search everywhere. There were only a few places that I got to before I found that Ricky's in BC. So fingers crossed, if you're looking for one, you can find one wherever you are. And again, I know this is not a comic book video. I know it's not related to comics directly, more so than cleaning thing. But thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.